Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And I know, well, no, actually every week I have been uploading, so yeah, it's just that I've pre-filmed the video, so it feels like I haven't actually been in front of the camera for a while. Anyway, it is a beautiful day today, but it's still kind of winter here in Australia, hence the sweater. Trying out a new setup, so tell me if it works for you. Anyway, I went thrifting, or I went to the op shop. It's called op shops here in Australia. I went to the op shops, and there's one in particular that is very near to my house, and it's also got really good things inside there. And I went there today, only searching really for a white blazer, because I bought these from eBay for cheap, and I guess you get what you pay for, because it really is kind of cheap and it looks really boxy. And this one in particular looks like a lab coat that somebody stole from the morgue or something like that. This is the exact same cut, except that it's bright blue. So yeah, not really my kind of thing. It didn't even look anything like how it was advertised on eBay. So I thought, you know what, I'm gonna pass this on to whoever would like to take it. It also is quite large for me. I did go one size up with the idea that it's going to be an oversized fit, but you know, if you get these, it's better to just stick true to your size, because they really do run large, and fabric was really yucky, you know, I don't really like it. So and I know that is counterintuitive to what I'm trying to do, which is to stop buying stuff, or you know, buying secondhand, so that so that I can reduce the use. And that was a really bad decision on my end. This came new from eBay from a factory in China. Obviously, I don't even know whether they use child labor or whatever. That was a really bad impulse purchase on my end, and so I'm actually gonna donate this. Maybe somebody else would be happy to have it. It's like a beautiful color, the blue one, but it's just too bright for me that I can't really wear it. It's hard to pair it with anything. Anyway, so I went to the op shop, and while I was looking for the white blazer, I did find the white blazer that I want, which is this tailored white blazer. It's double breasted, and look at the detail of that button. You see that? It's beautiful, and it's the same buttons that are in the front right there. So there's double-breasted ones. The tailoring of this one is, it's not white, it's a bit like off-white. It's not cream either, but it's just like, it's not a stark white and not like blindingly white as the other one that I had, which looked like a lab coat. So yeah, it's nicely tailored. It's got that fit at the back, as opposed to this one that I got that is just like, I don't know. Yeah, cheaply made with cheap material, but I still paid more for this than this, because this was $15. And I think I paid something like $26 for this one. Sorry about that. I don't know why somebody is honking their car so loudly. That's just rude, man, rude. Anyways, so I got this, and it's from the brand Events, which I'm not familiar with. I was told that they used to have a shop at Pitt Street Mall here in Sydney, but they've closed down, and I think that was about 9 years ago. So this must be maybe 10 years old. Doesn't matter, it looks pristine. There's no like yellow stains on it or anything like that that you would sometimes find in yellow clothing. And while I was there, I also found another one that is from a similar brand. Different kind of collar or lapel. This one is also double-breasted, and the buttons that it has is more like a half pearl kind of thing, and it's the same buttons that it has here in the front. This one is a little bit more, has got more of a silhouette that's more flattering for females. But I was thinking that these are blazers that I can wear coming into the spring, where I'll have like a light shirt underneath, or a cami, the pair of jeans and blazers, and you know the drill. It's all over Instagram, it's all over the fashion blogs about looking smarter by putting on a third layer, which are which is usually a blazer. So these are really smart blazers by the brand Events. Don't know if they still exist really. If they do, you might want to check them out because it looks like they're really good at tailoring their blazers. $15 each, so $30. Okay. And then I also found this pair of trousers. Really long. It's a little too long for me, to be honest, but if I wear heels, it's gonna be just right, like hitting the floor just right. It's wide leg. I love how it falls and how it flows. Like, the material is so nice. It's got double hooks over there. It's got that design. It's zip up. It has pockets on the sides. There seems to be like a faux pocket here. I don't understand why people do that. Like, why do you even pretend that there's a pocket there when there isn't? Is it like extra fabric to make it look like you've got a bum? Don't know. And how it folds at the bottom, it's got that little hemming over there. So what I'll probably try to do is, if it's really gonna be too long for me, is I'm gonna try and hem it another way so that it would fit me and suit me better. Okay. Oh, and by the way, this is by the brand Ann Taylor Loft, L-O-F-T. And it says here it's a size 6, but you know with this American brand, a size 6 is actually an Australian 10 or a UK 10. So don't be misled by the labels. Try them on and see if it fits you, especially with American brands, because their sizing is different from Australian and UK brands. And this, funnily enough, is made in the Philippines. I'm also made in the Philippines. And lastly, I did get this. I saw it as I was walking out and I thought it just looked gorgeous. It's a denim dark wash with gold stitching. Don't know if you can see the gold stitching. And I love the buttons, the front. And it's a size 10, it's by Jag, and it's got pockets in the front as well. It's not very deep pockets, like he'd probably put cash on there, like, I don't know. So I saw this and I was like, yeah, that's mine. And I really like it. I can't wait for the summer when I can wear it, or even spring. I can probably wear this in my early spring. Now, the two pairs of jeans that I have hanging here are two jeans that I bought previously. And I thought I would show you as well. This light wash one, it's a light wash gray pair of jeans. This is by Levi's. I'm not actually sure if I have already shown this to you guys. And lastly, this is something that I bought from eBay. It was new without tag, so she's already bought it, but I don't think she's ever worn it. It's by the brand Diesel Industry. You know that one of my favorite pairs of jeans is from Diesel, but these things cost a fortune. Like, the outlet shop over at, DFO at Homebush sells their, and that's an outlet shop, sells a pair of Diesel for about, like, I think the cheapest is $99, and that's when it's at 50% off sale. They usually run around $200 for a pair of Diesel jeans. And I saw this on eBay, hasn't worn it. You can see the label and everything that's still attached there. It's a size, I think this is a size 29 as well. Yeah, it's a size 29. It's got the label at the back, yeah. And what I liked about this is it looks a bit like a cargo style. I think it's more like a carpenter pants, because look at how the pockets are at the back. And it's got this side pocket here as well, where I usually drop my phone. Yeah, and it's button fly jeans with this little, I don't know what this one is for. Maybe somebody can tell me. Yeah, what is that for? Yeah, it's a size 29, it's 100% cotton. Yeah, there we go. So yeah, I saw this, and how much did I pay for this? Let me just double check. I try to go onto eBay if I want to get something, just because everything has already been made. Like, whatever you want, it's already out there. Somebody probably owns it and wants to get rid of it, so if you can get it secondhand, maybe that's the way to go. How much was this thing? It was $26.25, plus $9 shipping. So yeah, that was pretty cool. I like this. Yeah, so it was $26 for something that is new without tag. Not bad. Yeah, I do like the structure of this, so I think that was a win. So those are my recent purchases, and like this one is like really recent, like today, like an hour ago. I went to the op shop and I found them. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean them before I use them. And I think that's it. Let me know in the comment section down below what you have recently purchased, if you have started looking into your local op shops or thrift shops. Like I know in America, like Savers and what's the other ones? Goodwill. Here in Australia, it's Vinnie's and Vinnie's and Salvos, or yeah, Salvation Army. Vinnie's is St. Paul. I don't know what St. Paul, St. Vincent de Paul, that's what it is. Okay, so anyway, I'm rambling on. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know if you enjoyed this video, if you want me to continue showing you what I've thrifted. And I will also be on August 25, there's going to be a Sydney suitcase rummage, which I showed you before in a previous video that I attended. But this time around, I'm actually participating by bringing my own suitcase and selling some of my clothes that I have either worn a few times or not, never at all. So if you are within the Sydney area and you want to participate or have a look at what's available at the Sydney Suitcase Rummage, then please come on August 25. I will be there with my suitcase full of my shiz that I haven't used. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Thank you very much. And I will see you all again in the next video. Bye.